Dear students, today we will discuss about the periodic classification. Student, first I will tell you that what is classification. Classification is a process by which elements having similar properties are grouped up together and separate those which differ from them. The next question is why we classify the elements. RM of classification. The M of classification is to make the study of element easy. Classification always based on certain properties. Dear students, as you know that today we are discussing about periodic classification. The periodic classification is a orderly arrangement of elements on the base of their properties. Students, as you know that in the beginning elements, scientists do not have too many information about the elements, so classification was not too good. But with the passage of time, chemists get more and more information about the elements, and classification will become better and better. Number of scientists work for the development of periodic table, but most important scientists which take part in the development of periodic table are Al-Razi, Daubner, Newland, Lothermeyer, Mendeleev and Moseley. Now we discuss the work of each scientist. Number one, Al-Razi. Al-Razi was a Muslim scientist who first time classify elements on the base of their properties into groups. These groups were metal and non-metal, and he also explained the properties of metal and non-metal. This classification was not too good because too many information about the properties of element are not available. Students, you Daubner classification. Daubner arranged the elements on the base of their atomic mass in 1829. First, I will tell you about atomic mass. Sum of protons and neutrons which are present in the nucleus of an atom is called atomic mass. Daubner arranged the elements in two groups, and each group contains three elements. So Daubner group is called triads, which means the group of three elements. Students, now we will discuss the method for the preparation of triad. Now arithmetic mean of first and third element of triad is just equal to the atomic mass of second element of the triad. Three triads are shown in the table. Student, first we discuss triad number one, which contain lithium, sodium and potassium. Now arithmetic mean of lithium and potassium is equal to the mass of sodium. As you know that mass of lithium is 7 and mass of potassium is 39. When we get their arithmetic mean, which is shown in table, it is equal to 23, which is atomic mass of sodium. Remaining two triad you will solve at home. Now I will tell you how we can calculate mean. The formula for mean is sum of term upon number of term is called mean. Now students, we study the advantages and disadvantages of Daubner classification. Advantage: he laid the foundation of classification of elements in two groups. Disadvantages: no fixed position for groups. Number two, he is not able to arrange all the known elements. Newland. Dear students, next attempt was made by English chemist Newland. between 1864 to 1869. Newland also arranged the elements on the base of their atomic mass in tabular form. Now, dear student, in tabular form, every element have fixed position in the row and column. Daubner period table have 7 groups. Newland established relationship between properties and atomic mass of element, and he gave his laws. Newland law. Every 8th element have properties similar to first one. Newland arranged elements into 7 groups. 2 rows of his groups are shown on screen. Now, his first row was lithium, beryllium, boron, carbon, nitrogen, oxygen, and fluorine. And second row was sodium, magnesium, aluminium, silicon, phosphorus, sulfur, and chlorine. We count element from left to right in a row. If we start counting from beryllium, the 8th element will be magnesium, which have properties similar to beryllium. The same way, if we start counting from carbon, 8th element will be silicon. So silicon and carbon have same properties. Now, student, we look at the advantages and disadvantages of Newland's classification. Advantages: this law provide base for the classification of elements into groups of element having similar properties, or we can say that element present in the same column or group have same properties. Number 2, Newland arrange all the known elements. Disadvantage: Newland's classification have one disadvantage, which is he is not able to arrange. His periodic table do not contain noble gases, because noble gases was not discovered at that time. Dear students, now we discuss the Lothermeyer's classification. Lothermeyer is a German scientist. Lothermeyer arranged elements on the base of their increasing atomic mass in tabular form. Lothermeyer gave his periodic table in 1864 and then extended it in 1869. His periodic table contained 56 elements. Lothermeyer also introduced the concept of periodicity. Student, now I will tell you about periodicity. Students, repetition of elements having similar properties after particular interval is called periodicity. Lothermeyer plot graph between different properties as the graph between atomic volume and atomic mass. On the base of these graphs, Lothermeyer gave his law, Lothermeyer's law. Elements having same position in the curve or graph will show same properties. Now, if we look at the graph flashed on your screen, alkali metals, lithium, sodium, potassium, rubidium, and cesium are present at the top of curve, so they will have same property. In the same way, halogens, fluorine, chlorine, bromine, iodine are present in the middle of graph ya curve, so they have same properties. And all the third A group elements are present in the bottom of curve or graph, so they will have same properties. Lothermeyer's classification do not get proper attention due to following reasons. Number 1, Lothermeyer's classification was supported by number of graphs, and it is compulsory to have these graphs to understand Lothermeyer's classification. Number 2, in the same year, 1869, Mendeleev gave his periodic table, which is much better than the much better than Lothar-Mayer's classification. Dear students, we will discuss Mendeleev and Moseley's classification in next lecture. Thank you.